So carrying on from the EICR that I'm doing today, this is the obviously the consumer unit that we're looking at, that I'm working on. So I have already been doing some work on it, but this is generally the condition that I found it in. So a couple of things to look at is straight away, we can see the 25 mil tails. It's a metal consumer unit and they come through on individual holes, which is, that's no good because that can cause an issue with the magnetic effect between the conductors. Again, the 16 mil main earth comes through a separate hole and it should really come in together with the tails, so they're unsupported, so that's something that's going to be picked up. Let's look at the condition of everything else. We've got the grey here. This is an armoured cable, so this grey cable has been used as the CPC or the neutral. Again, it shouldn't really be done like this, it should be the other way around. So the black should really be used for the CPC because the black is the old neutral colour, and so as a general rule we always use the grey as the neutral. Again, there's no sleeving on it. This is a 1.5 mil cable that feeds the outside shed. I haven't looked at anything else yet, but it looks like it is an armoured cable. If you can't see, you can't see behind there, but it's obviously not glanded correctly. There's no brass gland on there, so the outer braiding isn't connected. You can't necessarily see it, but let's check the torque settings for how sort of tight the connectors are. Now I have been messing around with the ring circuit, so I won't do this one. That's half turn. I won't check that one yet. Half a turn. So again, half a turn or so on those. So actually not too bad. They should be around the 2.4 newton meter setting. Again, we've got the main earth and the bonding conductors. But in general, it's not necessarily as bad as what some boards that we see, but it's not perfect. Again, there's an open grommet there. And again, if we look on the top boards, the IP rating here isn't maintained neither. So so that's something that we would perhaps have to put some silicone around there. I don't like doing it, but for the IP rating, there's not really much other things that we can do. So yeah, anything else that you can find? Again, something I'm going to look into. We've got the shower circuit and the cooker circuit. They're both wired up in 6 mil and they're both protected by a 40 amp breaker, which certainly for the cooker, it probably doesn't need to be 40 amps, but it might be a concern for the shower that it's a 40 amp because it is only a 6 mil cable. So that's something that we'll have to investigate in a second when we do the shower. And again, if you look at the board, this is the front of the board. So it's a lovely, it's a nice Crabtree board. But again, there's no stickers. The labels on here are limited. They don't give you an awful lot of information. We have got the pack here. So it's got the RCD sticker, etc. But there's other things that need to be on there. So for example, non-standard colours. So you've got the brown and the blue and the red and the black. So that also needs to be looked at. Another thing is I haven't checked the lighting circuits yet, but apparently the lighting circuits don't have a CPC. So again, that would have to be another sticker we'd have to put on just to show what circuits haven't got the CPC on. But apart from that, anything else you can find? I hopefully that should all be okay.